All right. First off, if you're watching this, it's because you probably have shared some concerns about health with me in the past, or I've seen some things. And I wanted to help you because I'm not going to tell you I'm some guru or know so much about health and nutrition, but I know enough to give you some insight as to what's going on in most cases, okay? And listen or not, I mean, I hope you listen to this video in its entirety because I'm going to give you some tips and some hints, but I'm going to share with you what it is that's going on in maybe your body, and then I'm going to share with you how you can become stronger, okay? So first, if you're going through a struggle right now with your health, it's really health struggles, dis-ease, right? It's called dis-ease, and dis-ease happens here and happens in our bodies. Dis-ease means the act of not being eased, if you will. But dis-ease is something that lives within our bodies. Now, the way that dis-ease forms, any type of disease, anything from literally cancer, a cold, the flu, whatever, all of these things form because of a excessive amount of acid in our body, acidity. Well, acid creates what we call disease today. And the way it creates it is because your body is supposed to be naturally balanced in acid, meaning acidity. If you think back to high school, there used to be this thing called the pH scale. And the pH scale says how much acid is in something. And when you increase or when you inject or induce or introduce foreign liquids, foods, processed foods, things of that nature, it counteracts your body's natural ability to stay balanced. And so because of that, what happens is you, of course, become full of disease. Now, when you think about acidity, don't think about, you know, literally, you know, think about the things that acid, like acid itself, just think about your blood itself is not able to stay calm. So when something has acid in it, it becomes in danger. So your cells start breaking down. Your immune system is not as strong, so it can't fight off bacteria and it can't fight off infection. So it all starts with acid. And the way that acid is created, again, is by introducing foreign things into itself, into the body. And the way you do that is through things that are not normal, right? Think about humans as they've been primordial from back in the days, if you will, from ancient Greeks to before that, the caveman. When they eat something, when they consume something, they consumed things that were natural, literally natural. You know, there was nothing processed about them. They were pretty much things that you could gather in your hands and kill or pick in a day, and that's what you would eat and consume. Today's world doesn't give us that luxury anymore. We buy processed food. We buy potato chips. We drink Cokes instead of water. We find things that are, you know, put, you know, genetically mutated, if you will, and we put them into our body, and our body is just not made to handle those things. They're just not. So what the cure to things are is to try to get back to that natural state. And the way you do that is through the consumption of raw and fresh foods. Raw and fresh foods. And I know that's a hard deal when maybe some people or even myself have not really been in that world, but it's the one thing that I know will solve the problem, because when you eat raw and unprocessed foods, what happens is you are now neutralizing the acidity of your body, which causes disease to go away. It goes away. It fights it. And every time you let's say, drink a Coke or an alcoholic beverage, anything with sugar in it, you are now introducing disease again, or you're feeding disease. You're feeding it, not introducing, you're feeding a disease. Anytime you add water into your body, anytime you add natural juices into your body, you are now fighting disease. So think about it from a perspective of what would work, right? So no more glasses of Coke or wine or beer or margaritas. You change it with a glass of water with lime in it. Now, lime and lemon, even though they may sound like they're acidic, are actually counteractive. They actually break down acid. So anytime you can put lime or lemon in a water, you're definitely counteracting disease. Now, let me give you some advice on some things you should be thinking about eating or drinking. Lots of greens, fresh greens, you know, for an example, broccoli, but not boiled broccoli because you take out all the nutrients, just raw broccoli, raw vegetables, anything that you can get that's green in your hands, you know, anything green, green beans, green broccoli, green lettuce, green bell peppers, green avocado. These are all things that you can introduce into your body that fight acid. If it's green, it fights acid. If it's green, it fights acid. So introduce some greens into your body. You know, get in a healthy rhythm. And if you can't eat them, drink them, juice them. Sounds crazy, but you can juice. Find a recipe for a mean green, green apple, some ginger. These are things that add to your immune system and fight disease on your behalf. Everything that you consume resides in what we call our gut or our colon. Now, the reason that I'm sharing that with you is because the best and most fastest way to cleanse, if you will, is to eat greens and raw vegetables, because your body will start pushing all the junk out of your colon. Your colon is where actually most disease lives. That's where disease forms, and it spreads throughout your body from your colon because of the foods that we eat that our body cannot process. So if you think about this, one of the ways that you can start this whole process really is to go through a real good cleanse of just eating vegetables and raw foods. I would avoid fatty meats. I would avoid meat altogether if you can. If you could just eat fish, that would be great. And it needs to be a clean fish, not like a tilapia. I'd talk about a salmon or something. Those are good fish. If you can't go that far, eat some chicken, but eat white breast, not fat meat, not dark meat, white meat, turkey, white meat. These are things that are going to help you cleanse your body. Now, I'm going to add a few tips in here, okay? So drink juices, and I don't mean those powdered juices from, you know, Herbalife. That crap, just to be clear, I hate to disrespect them, but it's just crap. You need raw, real vegetables. You need raw, real juices. You need real food, not just shakes. That's unnatural. Again, it's genetically modified. It is produced. It's processed. It's not raw. It's not fresh. Think about the freshness, okay? All right, so eat clean, drink clean. Now let me add some things. Your body needs to get cardiovascular movements. It needs your blood to flow. Walking, jogging, moving. Those are things that you need to do. You need to move your body as much as you possibly can so that your cardiovascular and your immune system can jump up. Also, a multivitamin, very important. Adding a multivitamin would be killer right now. A good multivitamin, complete multivitamin is good. A probiotic is very good. Probiotics are made to stimulate the gut and exit, you know, to get things out. I would introduce probably a zinc in there. These are pills you can all buy at maybe at Walmart. You can buy them at Vitamin Shop, Target. But you need to add these things into your diet. Now, I'm not some health guru or anything. I did go to an event. And I paid a lot of money to learn about all these things, about nutrition and health and how to keep your body pure. I don't follow it as much as I need to, but I do as much as I can. I do my multivitamin. I do the zinc. I do the juicing. I do this every day, by the way. And I do this to help my immune system stay strong and to fight off disease. I get as much greens as I possibly can. And I drink a ton of water every single day. And I try to avoid sugar as much as possible. Sugar is the enemy, just to be clear. Sugar is your enemy. I hope this helps. I know there's probably more I can give, but if you'd like to ask more questions or need some more insight, I'd love to help you. I hope that you know that I'm coming from a place of health, of not health, but health too, but of help. I don't want to be a teacher to you and just tell you to listen to me. I want you to be the student here and make your own determinations. Okay. I appreciate you guys and everybody who watches this. I love you so much. I hope your health improves and your quality of life gets better, because those of us around you depend on you, need you, love you, care about you, and need you around forever and ever and ever. So don't ever give up on yourself. Stay motivated, stay positive, but most importantly, focus on you. Thanks, guys.